Hearty welcome to Alan's Tutorials, your English literature class for the students of class 9 and 10 based on the ICAC pattern for the immediate preparation of your board and other exams. This class is taken by Joseph Little Flower School, Salempur. Chief Seattle's speech. Chief Seattle was born in the year 1786 and died in the year 1866. This speech is a translated version and it is done by Dr. Henry A. Smith, who lived from 1830 to 1915. You have to understand some of the figures living at that time. George Washington, the president at that time. Franklin Pierce, the president again. Governor Isaac Stevens, the image again you can find. Presidents of US at that time, that is Franklin Pierce and George Washington. And of course, this is the figure of Chief Seattle. He was the head of the tribal group. Who was Chief Seattle? He was the 19th century leader of Squamish tribe in the Washington Territory in America. He is so famous for his speech. This speech is delivered just before his lands were taken from him and his people by the white colonizers. This speech is in response to Governor Stevens' proposed land treaty. The themes of this particular speech: Red Indians' attachment to their land, oppression of these black people by the white colonizers, the tribal belief system, Western belief system, clash of civilization, that is black and white, then transcendence, moving away, environmental concerns. These are the themes that we are going to pay attention in the story or in the speech. The setting of this particular story, that is very important, you have to understand. Chief Seattle, known for his love for his land, it is believed that Governor Stevens spoke to them of the terms of the proposed treaty, which later came to be known as the Treaty of Point Elliot of 1855. The treaty between US government and Native American tribes. Thus, speech is the reaction to white settlers' proposal of buying native lands. The highlights of the speech, let us understand. Nature's sympathetic role in the lives of Chief Seattle's tribe. Then youth's impulsive nature led them into war and destroyed them. Everything on the earth has life. Earth is sacred. Ironic references to George Washington as native's good father. The god of the whites is different from the native's great spirit who guides them through their traditions. For the natives and their ancestors, their land and culture is sacred. The natives and the whites will have a common fate. The native tribes would agree to sell the land only if they are allowed the privilege of visiting their land. The whites will never be alone. The land will swarm with the invisible dead of the Seattle tribe. These are the highlights of this particular speech. Let us understand something about the introduction of this particular speech. Chief Seattle's speech is a heartfelt speech to the governor of the state of Washington. The speech was published on a very large scale, in which he argued in favor of ecological responsibility and respect of land rights of Native Americans. Although what he actually said has been lost through translation and writing, the speech was published in Seattle newspaper in 1887 by a pioneer who confirmed that he had heard him delivering it in 1854. Apart from this, no other record has been found. Let us go through the summary of this beautiful speech. Chief Seattle delivered the speech to mark the transfer of ancestral Red Indians' land to the federal government. He says that the great chief in Washington sends greetings of friendship and goodwill and wishes to buy their land. This is kind of his part, as he has little need of their friendship in return, because his people are strong and more powerful than the native Red Indians. The Chief Seattle recalls the time when his people were larger in number, but now they are reduced to a mournful memory. But he will not mourn over their untimely decay. The young men are too aggressive and want to take the revenge even at the cost of their own lives, but the old men are wise and do not want to continue their hostile attitude towards them. It was the time when the white men pushed their forefathers westward. He wishes that George Washington, who he calls as their good father, will protect them. His brave warriors will protect them from ancient enemies. Then he encounters a fear that the God of white people is not their God. He only loves his people. He makes the pale face stronger and has forsaken his red children. He cannot love his Red Indian children, so how can they be brothers? They seem to be orphans. Thus, he says that they are two different races with separate origins and separate destinies. There is little in common between them. He further remarks that the ashes of his ancestors are sacred, and their resting place is that land, whereas the whites wander away from the graves of their ancestors. The white man's religion was written upon the stone tablets by the iron fingers of their God, but the Red Indian's religion is the tradition of their ancestors. He then says that their dead men ceased to love them, the whites, but the red man's ancestors can never forget this beautiful world. They keep on loving its verdant valleys, murmuring rivers, magnificent mountains, valleys, lakes, and bays. He remarks that red man has ever fled the approach of the white man as the morning mist disappears before the morning sun. Grim fate seems to follow them, and soon his race will disappear. But then Seattle says that they will consider the matter, and before accepting President's proposition, he had put forth the condition that they will not be denied to visit the tombs of their ancestors, friends, and children any time. He concludes his speech by saying that when the last red man has vanished from the earth, His memory will become myth, and the shores and forests will hold the fruits of his tribe. The white man will never be alone. He urges the white men to love and care the land as they did with all their strength, mind and heart. Love and preserve it as God loves and preserves us. He believed that the dead of his community were the part of his world, and said that there is no death but only a change of worlds. Whom they were, Big Chief refers to U.S. President Governor George Washington. Real president at that time was Franklin Pierce. White Chief refers to Governor Isaac Stevens. The beautiful portraits you can find here. Critical appreciation of this beautiful speech. The background of this speech is the background of imperialism, where white people were making colonies everywhere, especially attacking and destroying black people. It is a painful depiction of war, and it is institutionalized Christianity. White people, most of them belong to Christian religion, and this one. So land treaty, once again you have to remember that. See, the white chief sent the letter telling that you sell your land and definitely we will take care of you, we will protect you. We will protect you from your old enemies like Haidas. Hope you have understood the speech. Please, dear students, please read by yourself, make the notes. And this is just a helping tool that I have provided you. Hope with your understanding, hope you are reading, with your reading, you will understand the speech in the best possible way. Thank you.